Hi folks, Lance here from TriggerShims.com. I wanted to take a minute and show you about the bolt shims that I make for the Ruger 77 22 rifles. These will fit actually any of these two-piece bolts that come in the Ruger 77 22 or the 77 17. And these bolt shims, what we're going to do with these, there's a lot of play in these two bolt halves on some of these rifles. We're going to take some of that play out by shimming between the two bolt halves. Real easy to do. All you have to do, we'll hold the bolt in our hand. We're going to hold the bolt handle with our left hand. I'm going to put my thumb right over the safe. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn this clockwise about a quarter of a turn. Okay. Now that's going to line up my hole here where my pin is that holds my front half of the bolt. And all I've got to do is come in from behind with a punch. Small diameter punch and push that pin right on out of there. It's not anything I have to drive out. When it's lined up, it'll just push right out like that. Set that down and just slide the bolt apart. It's that simple. Now you'll notice on the bolt there's a couple flats right here where the hole is, where the pin goes through. Get those up here so you can see those. There you go. Can you see those flat spots? And then the pin itself, there's a couple flat spots on the head. You see those flat spots there? So when that sets down in, those flat spots set in that hole right there, okay? Not very hard to do. So what we want to do is we want to take our shim. These shims will just fit right over here like this. Slide it back together. Drop the pin in. You may need to do a little wiggling around. You may need to push it in and to seat it finally with your punch. And then grab your bolt in the back here where the safe is with your thumb. And let's turn it a quarter of a turn approximately back counterclockwise until it hits the detent right here. Okay? And that's it. That lines our bolt back up. It's ready to put in and try it out. You don't want it too tight. Don't make it so that you really have to reef on your bolt handle to close it. We don't want to put any excessive wear on your receiver or your bolt. What we want to do is just take enough of this play out so we get a consistent seating of our cartridge. Now a couple other things that I want to show you here. We do make also some trigger and sear shims. If you decide you want to take your trigger mechanism and shim that up, put some little shim washers like little bearings in there and stop some of the side-to-side play, get everything kind of centered up and smooth. We've got the shims for your trigger for your 77-22. I also carry the Wolf spring packs for the 77-22. That has the 23-pound striker spring and the little sear, reduced power sear trigger spring there. I carry the 77-22 target sears, which is a drop-in target sear. Will reduce your trigger pull on the rifle. It comes also with a reduced power spring on that too, and that's made by Volkhortsen. So all these things are available at the website, TriggerShims.com. But especially I hope these 77-22 bolt shims will help you out. We do sell these in assortments. We've got 4-piece, 8-piece assortments, 12, 24, however many you want to buy. The basic 4-piece assortment gets most guys pretty much what they need. You'll get a shim in 2/1000ths, a 3/1000ths, a 4/1000ths, and a 5/1000ths shim in a 4-piece assortment. So there you go, folks. Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate your time. I hope this helps you out. And stop by our website and have a look around, TriggerShims.com. Till then, we'll look forward to seeing you. Take care, good shooting, and God bless.